Hey guys, it is me, Hannah, and welcome back to another episode of the SMP. So welcome back to episode 4, I'm pretty sure. So in this episode, we have a few things to go over. So number one, the main thing will be the Nether. We, as a group, we went to the Nether. It's like a little trip. But just to start off with the intro, I think I'm going to head to spawn and show you guys a little something, because some stuff has actually happened. We've been working on spawn. Now, some of it has probably changed because I have been at school. Look at these creepers blowing up everything. I've been at school, so I haven't, I don't know if they've done anything else, but I can remember the last thing that, I actually have a looting 3 sword, so let's see if we can get that bow. We cannot, but I'll take the bones. Oh, and also we need to restock up on, my things. But I did end up getting diamond armor, full diamond armor, which is really good. And I put my sharpness 3 and looting 3 sword together. I enchanted all my diamond armor at level 30. So let me just quickly read it out on my helmet. We've got that, and that. So I need to get unbreaking on my boots, but the rest of it's pretty good. I got respiration 3 book from fishing a little bit, because I did some fishing. I enchanted a fishing rod at level 30, and I got Luck of the Sea 3, Unbreaking 3, and also I got Lure 3. So I got some good enchant on that, so I got the respiration book. I think it helps with being underwater, but I'm not too sure. I don't really know what respiration does. I know the Aquafinity gives you more, like, time underwater, but what does respiration do? I don't know. I'm clueless, but, if we head to spawn, nothing's really happened, so Sam's house is still here. He did this really big, weird bridge, but, and I also put a staircase here for easy access down here, because, you know, I always go up this hill. Just so bad, I'll make it look prettier later, but for now, it's just something. Something just gonna be there. This is Emma's house, if you guys don't know. She finally built a house and it looks really cute. And there's Julia's house over there. Enchanting table. Oh, she put an anvil. That's cute. That is so cute. I can see spawn now. I'm gonna have my head down because I wanna show you guys when we get there. I feel like I'm running slower. Oh, you saw it a little bit. Okay. Let's not. Ow. Let's not. Come on. God, I feel so slow running right now. I think I'm gonna live. Oh, they did do some work. Okay, well, this is spawn. This is just kind of the start of. Actually, did I finish it? No, I think we're adding more stuff into it, but basically, this is kind of like the basic spawn at the moment. So we've got, it's so cute, I know, like honestly I can't even get over it. So I was here helping build the fountain and everything. The archway, like this stone brick thing, wasn't here before, but we built like the paths and all that, and the pathway design, this is what it's gonna be. And it looks adorable. So it's a bit magical kind of feel to it, which is really cute. So that's a little bit of update on what's happening with spawn. So I actually need to restock up on this and see if we've got any payments. Bam. Oh, got some more chicken happening here. And potatoes. Any payments? 2 gold blocks. Thank you. I will take that very much. But I think that's going to be it for this intro. Not much is going to be happening this episode besides the Nether, a few little more of an update, and we'll see what happens. I'm filming this before I film any of the other clips, but I do have a basic outline on what I want to do. I don't think I'm going to be doing any collabs. Probably just the group recording to the Nether. So, yes.
Hey guys, and welcome to our Anthea Nether journey episode part. Hey!
Hi!
Where do you guys want to want to build this portal, should we just do it right here? Because we can always move it. Don't kill each other.
Yeah, but I don't, like...
Break my armor and you're all dead!
Once we, like, actually build the farm, we can always move it.
Hey guys, has anyone got a flint and steel?
Yeah.
Oh, thank God.
The most prepared. Alrighty.
Set me a light. Set me a light.
Let's go!
Exciting.
We need to.
Yes, we do.
I'm gonna hang back here. So that
I'm gonna go deeper in your pussy.
I'm lagging so much. Am I there or?
I'm like not even going anywhere.
Me too. Oh, here we go.
Is it okay? It's safe. It's
safe. No, we're
fine. No, it's all safe. Wow, thanks, Emma. I feel awesome tonight. Okay, alrighty. Bed or water?
The purpose of today's exercise is to so that we can get ender chests and so
exercise.
That we can and so that we can
exercise.
Get a bit of XP.
Little thing. How do I make an ender chest?
Hold on. How dare you steal my quartz?
So Eye of Ender.
Yo,
I don't even have an Ender Pearl.
Okay,
no,
how do I
get
an Eye of Ender? Connor, I was coming to these!
Alright, so basically we're looking for blazes.
Yes.
So basically we're looking for another fortress.
Connor! Run!
Wait, you found a fortress?
No,
no, I just
found lava because I was going ham with my pickaxe.
You found lava!
Oh, this is far too fast for this.
Oh, rip. Connor.
Yeah, I know. I feel like biggest risk of death in Nether is like pickaxe.
Well, yeah.
Especially with how quickly things can break due to.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like,
mine don't break that so fast since I just brought a normal iron pickaxe.
I have an
effect. Wait, did any of you guys have feather falling on your boots?
No.
I do.
No.
And I can literally fall 22 blocks and take one hard.
Wait, Emma, what do you have?
Feather falling.
Oh, I have feather falling too.
It only cost me one level.
Cause yeah, we all like leveled up and like kind of tried to get some somewhat okay stuff before we came.
It's brilliant, cause it's just like I can just throw myself off stuff and not have to worry about dying.
I know, I love it when one of us just throws himself off things.
Emily, I see you.
Hey.
Hey. Let's stick together. Let's go get find some glowstone.
All right, let's go.
I see some over here. Oh.
Alright, let's just hit them.
Oh, that was really creepy. My leg moved on my chair, and it's kind of numb, and I thought it was something up against my leg, and I was like, my cat isn't in here.
Guys, I'm burning.
I'm
dying.
I keep doing Survival Island. I keep pressing tap to get my heart to
die. Never.
Me too. Huntley, let's get this glowstone up here.
Wait, Max, right. Where are you, Max?
Why aren't I gonna... Oh god, I'm gonna die. I'm... No.
Tell me your cords.
No! My life.
No!
Oh, and okay, I'm all the way back at my house as well.
Where did you...
We probably should have set our spawn at zero, like, at spawn.
I, like... Oh, it doesn't matter. Do you know what? Died so many times, I give up.
No, I'm finding this.
I could probably get there. Okay. I don't know how to explain where I went.
Huntley, we'll half whatever this whatever we get from this glowstone.
Alright.
No, I went down.
I'll break it all.
I found another fortress, or at least a little bit of one.
Right. Oh, where?
I'm not gonna make this.
Okay, throw me what you have and I'll half it.
I'm finding where this stuff is and I'm gonna get it for you.
I didn't get much.
Okay, where are you?
Like,
what are your coordinates,
Igor.
I'm a dog.
Thank you.
Okay. I need to grab some building blocks. I need to some to like pillar up and stuff.
Okay, Hannah, I'm gonna owe you like a couple gold blocks because I'm gonna lose hunger and I need to run in the next.
For my food?
Yeah.
Okay.
I will pay. I've got the money. It's at Emma's house.
Alright.
This way. Don't mind me, Jordan. I am not good with the coordinates.
Why do you have to live
it's
so
okay. Oh, I see you guys. Me and Hannah are right above you. Hey.
Hey! Look up.
Hey. You wanna drop?
Yeah, oh heavens, I'm dead.
How did I?
I'm dead!
Die?
Pick up my shit!
You wanna drop?
Yeah, oh heavens, I'm dead.
How did
I? I'm dead!
Die?
Pick up my shit!
You wanna drop?
Yeah, oh heavens, I'm dead.
How did I?
I'm dead!
Die?
Pick up my shit!
Well,
oh my god, are you serious?
Oh my god.
your stuff, Hannah.
Go to 119.
Oh my gosh, I almost fell.
Wait, can you write it in the chat, please? I have to. I'm all the way back at my house. I need to run to spawn.
Oh no, I do. Let's raid.
Woo! I got Papa by my side.
There is literally nothing in this one.
I need Blaze. Nether wart.
Oh, whoops, sorry.
Oh my god, Alan Blaze. Oh
yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh my god.
Oh, Maxie stole it.
Sorry, I'll give you one. I'll take one as well because I did kill
it. Saddle! I don't have a saddle yet, so. Woo! My first saddle.
Oh, there's another blazer. Killed it.
I guess I'm going this way.
Oh.
O'Connor, I'll come with you.
Oh!
Oh,
I'm leaving it to my torches. Tiptoe! And in my window! I don't know that.
Oh, chat.
Ooh. Maxie Poo, I see you.
Where are my torches? Diamonds? I need to torch this up.
I hear blazes.
Oh, Connor, I see. I found a blaze spawner. Let's get it.
Oh, sick. Okay. Right.
Don't break it.
I see Emma and stuff.
Okay, how do you want to set this up so that we can farm it?
I found a wither.
Do you want to do it like this and we can shoot through?
Oh, so go ahead then.
Yeah, hold up. Hey.
Like this?
Emma, are you timing this episode by any chance? Oh, I've got two saddles.
Do you guys want to come to this blaze spawner?
No.
Yeah.
Oh, hey, there it is.
I'm in the blaze spawner right now.
You're at a different split up the blaze spawns that you get. Am I really fighting off a skeleton?
There we go.
Are you kidding me?
Oh my Jesus. I've let so many pigmen up.
Oh my god! Someone save me! I'm dead! Oh my god! No, honestly, I'm not kidding. Oh my god, I'm not kidding. I'm dead! I'm gone!
I let them all up to kill you, Hannah.
I think we'll kind of
Oh my lord.
Whatever you want.
Connor?
I don't know, I'm just enjoying myself.
You guys can end your episodes whenever, by the way. It's just because I'm editing it down to like 10 minutes that I'm just going to continuously record so we can put in all the best bits.
Yeah, I think I'm going to end my part here. The sun falls down on my beautiful house. I'm just gonna sit here with the sound of pigs and annoying cows and chickens and the most annoying thing ever. But anyway, okay, so as you guys just watched, I went to the Nether with everyone, and I've been to the Nether about like 5 times now, and got a lot of materials, won't lie. So I've got a Nether chest here, and basically, this is everything I've got. So, seeing as I have a living sword, I have found about 6 nether skeleton, wither skeleton skulls. I gave one to Emma, but I have 5, which is good. So, that means with the wither fight, hopefully, when we have one, I can get myself a beacon, which should be really fun and good, like to have like haste or speed around my house. And I've got so many blaze rods just because of my looting 3 sword. It's so good. And all these quartz are just from me mining to get levels. Like, it is like my source. Okay. But right now I've been mining and lost a lot of diamonds as well because of this expensive diamond armor, but I'm in love with it. So that's how much money I've got so far. It's pretty good. I won't lie, I'm not poor, which is always a good thing. But I've been making heaps of potions, and I've actually like made fire resistance, all sorts, because going to the Nether is very dangerous and you can die easily. So I made like instant health and all that kind of jazz. So this is all my Nether stuff. I'm pretty much lacking it so far. Also, if I quickly just want to head downstairs, if we head into my farm, I changed it up a little bit. If we head down, I've still got my carrots and then potatoes. I've put down here instead of the melons and stuff and pumpkins, because I have so many pumpkins and a watermelon. I just don't see any need for it. So I just put some netherwort and cactus down here just in case I will ever need it. Like the cactus and stuff. Also, I replaced the torches for glowstone, which is working out better for me. Everything's growing a bit faster. Also, another little update. I paid Emma 2 diamonds to give me 2 sheep. So I just got some sheep and bred them, and now I've got like a wool source. And Archie's still in here, fine. He's still alive. He is in love with, I was just about to start singing that Vine. Oh my god. Okay. I'm in love with, I'm in love? What? Am I in love? No. I don't know what I'm talking about. He's in love with that hay. So, I don't know. Also, I put my level 30 enchanting here, which I still got to build that downstairs thing. Just haven't had time yet. Hi, spider! My power 3 bow is going to slay him to death. I put like a little little dock here for me to go fishing. But right now, that was just like my little update on my house so far. I haven't done anything else to it really. Still the same as it used to be. But right now, I'm just going to head into a clip where I'm going to be showing off to you guys something that I've May. It's a beautiful morning here in Anthea, and I just woke up to the beautiful Enderman sound. Great, isn't that wonderful? I was about to say the beautiful sun rising, but you know what? The Enderman decided to completely ruin life for me. But there's the sun going up behind all the big, amazing oak trees. But I have something to show you guys. I've been caving a lot lately, and I've come across so many spawners. And a lot of them are really close to my house. But they're all spider spawners. Oh, there you are, you sneaky bugger. Do you wanna go, buddy? Let's go. Holy shivers! That's the first time I've ever killed an Enderman with a looting 3 sword. Do you want to go, bud? I just killed your person and I literally got 4 enderpearls. Look how many enderpearls I'm getting. Oh, there's that ratchet sound of the thing. But as you can see here, I have a lot of string. So now the reasoning behind that is because of my XP grinder. So it's not as good as the, or as advanced as the normal, skeleton spawner. I did find a skeleton spawner. I thought I saved the coordinates of it. And when I thought I found the coordinates, I went there and it was a spider spawner. And I was really confused because I was like, no, I already have a spider spawner. I only found 1 spider spawner. Why did a skeleton spawner turn into a spider spawner? I'm confused. But you know what? Let's live with it. So this is the way to the spider grinder. I didn't want to lose it, so I just made like a little torched way. I need to get rid of these leaves. They're so annoying. Even like a little bridge here I made just to make it easier for me. It's just right here it is. There's my little craft. Can this not even be a thing right now? Honestly, go away. Leave me. But if you come down these stairs here, if you just keep going down, it's only a level like 45 or something, so it's not that far down. You don't have to travel too far. But I might turn my hostile mob sound down just in case they're a bit loud for you guys. But basically, this is my spawner. I made this. It's kind of cute. I don't know. I made it look nice. Except the staircase. It's got this yuckiness. But basically, I just put water at the back and they come down to here. And then I can kill them from the bottom. But seeing as they're spiders, they can climb up basically anything. So I made a little staircase here just to hit them from up here. And if they fall back down to the ground, I kind of just... Yeah, they're a nuisance. Like, there's honestly, like... It's hard, but if I can't reach one, I like to bury them, which is the easiest way. And I've been collecting a lot of gravel for it, so okay, that failed. Let's kill you. Ow. But the XP and drops come down here. And it's pretty good. I think it gives me a little bit of levels. It's not like heaps good like a skeleton spawner, because skeleton spawners are quick. You just go like this and you get like 10 levels straight up. But this is just a quick way if I'm on like 28 levels and I want to get to 30 really quick, I just come down here for maybe like 5 minutes and I've got them extra levels to help me out. But this is my little spawner. It's open for any of the Anthea people, like any of my friends. If they need some quick levels, I am open to giving them the coordinates of this place. I guess it's kind of community, but more for me, seeing that it's like right next to my house. If you feel me, let me just get to 34 levels. Come on, levels. Oh, nearly there. See, it's not that advanced, but yet again, it does the job. I reckon it does the job really good. I'd like a skeleton spawner. That would be fun. That would be really sweet. When they got to the top, it frustrates me because I got to climb up my little staircase and come here to hit them. I'm going to burrow you. I'm at 34. Oh, there we go. So, this is just my little spawner. I just wanted to show that off to you guys. So, just a little bit of a random clip happening here because I don't really know what else. Oh, my mushroom. Where's my mushroom go? Oh, there it is. Just a little bit of a random clip happening here. Basically, as you can see, I've got no levels. It's because I just enchanted a sword at level 30, which only takes 3 levels away from you. And I got a pretty sweet sword, but it had Bane of Arthropods 4, not back to, it wasn't that good, but there was one thing that I enchanted it for, which was Fire Aspect. And when I went to the enchanting table, it said Fire Aspect 1, dot, dot, dot. So I got it and it had like yucky Bane of Arthropods. It didn't even have sharpness. So I just combined my Looting 3, Sharpness 3 sword with it and it got rid of Bane of Arthropods. And so basically I have a Sharpness 3, Looting 3, Knockback 2, Fire Aspect 1, and finally have Unbreaking on it. And it is awesome. Let's go actually test it out on my animals. Let's do this. I'm so happy you got Unbreaking on it and Fire Aspect so I don't have to cook my animals anymore. Hi, cows. Coming to murder you. Oh! One hit, and look, it's already cooked. This is like a dream. Look at them. And plus, knockback is awesome as well. Like if you're fighting a mobs and you just like hit them, it knocks them back just in case you're kind of low. Oh God, this sword is sweet. Look, 54 beef. If you guys want to go back and count how many things I just killed then, you're more than welcome to. I'm chucking them out just so I can see how many pork I get. Let's go. Let's do this. Go back and see how many things I've killed and tell me how many I killed. And I got 54 beef from like killing, I don't know, maybe 10, which is like the best thing ever because of this looting sword. And plus now it's cooked and it just makes me so happy. Look, already 4 levels back from just killing animals. How good's that? I got 49 pork on that. And now, oh my God, this is like the best thing ever. I love this sword so much. Like, it is my life. I'm living for it, like, so much. I think I'm going to leave this episode right here. I'm not sure the length of it. Usually I would test it. But just for the little outro, I actually just built a automatic fish farm. Now, I kind of did stuff it up a bit. Like, it was working properly. But I did stuff it up a bit because when I would fish, the fish wouldn't go in here. I actually had to move that raw salmon because, like, this fishing rod, it would go into this dropper and I'll be like, what? So I'm gonna rebuild it tomorrow, but just so you know, I've got an automatic fish farm now. But I hope you guys did enjoy this episode of Anthea SMP. So if you did enjoy it, don't forget to give this video a like and a big thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel and leave us just a sweet comment down below. Bye guys.